In the library module, there are quite a few different ways that you can customize the data that you see when in both the grid and the loop view. To get to these options, you can right-click and go down to View Options. It's also located in the menu as well. At the top, you can toggle back and forth between the grid view and the loop view. And for the most part, all of these changes are self-explanatory. The settings also change as you move things around and check different boxes, so it's really easy to see what it's going to look like when you are finished making all of your adjustments. One of the things I actually really like are these little thumbnail badges. They may not mean very much just by looking at them, but if you hover over them, you can actually see what they're referring to. And if you click on them, it will actually take you to those settings. Now, this just told me that I've made develop changes to this image, which is likely in almost all cases on my photos. There's always going to be some type of adjustment. But other things it tells me, and I'll go back into grid view, it's a little easier to see. It also tells me that this photo is in a collection. So if I click on that little thumbnail badge, it shows me the collections that it's in. In this case, it's only inside of the Quick collection, but if I were to click on that, it would take me into the Quick collection. It's also telling me that it has GPS coordinates embedded into the photo. So if I click on that, then it will show me the map view and where that image was photographed. In terms of the view modes, you can show as much or as little as you like. It's really up to you, and it's a very personal preference. Sometimes I change things around depending on what I'm doing or if I'm presenting photos inside of Lightroom in a teaching environment. But it's kind of a nice feature. You're able to keep things as detailed or as minimalistic as you like.